Some of history's greatest contribution have come from polymaths. Aristotle practically invented half a dozen fields of study across philosophy. Galileo was as much a physicist as he was an engineer when he helped kickstart the scientific revolution. Da Vinci might have been even more famous as an inventor than an artist if his notebook were ever published. Even in the last few decades, if we try to find out similarities among the founders of the world's five largest companies, we could zero it down on two. Each of them is a voracious learner. Each of them is a polymath. With the advent of IT and recent onset of the artificial intelligence, this debate of specialist versus polymath has come again into forefront. The discussion is on whether it's in the field of technology or administration. Let us try to understand this in a little bit detail. Specialization. Specialization is the process of concentrating on and becoming expert in a particular subject or skill. Specialization of field of education and profession is an ever-growing phenomenon. With greater and deeper development of various fields of science, technology, and even the social science, specialization is inevitable and even necessary in the contemporary world. This has yielded many important, even life-saving results. But with a focus on expertise, polymaths are becoming rare in the 21st century. So what are the perils of specialization? The expertism contributes to a host of problems that are being called the Anthropocene. The tragedy of specialization is that it leads to the members of knowledge industry to see little beyond their bulwarks, or for an engineer to understand why decentralized solar power that allows greater democratization among local communities is an opportunity to be grabbed instead of installing large solar parks by mega corporations. It therefore becomes difficult or impossible for an economist to appreciate the importance and value of biodiversity or why its loss is a major casualty. It is about ownership. Biodiversity, science, and soil, cross-cutting domains that super specialists will not be able to see. With increasing specialization, what one gets are experts who do not understand the connection between knowledge system and ways of knowing. While geoengineers say that we need to seed the upper atmosphere with exotic chemicals to cool the planet, there is rightly a hue and cry from many quarters. With renewable energy experts call for more biomass plantations, others worry about the displacement of farmers, the reduction of food production, and the loss of biodiversity. So, in this scenario, what is exactly a polymath? Polymath means a person of wide knowledge or learning. Among scholars and knowledge makers in history, one can identify a large number of intellectuals whose interests lay in disparate spheres. A poet, a philosopher could also be an astronomer, technical innovator, and mathematician. Consider, for instance, Galileo, Leonardo da Vinci, etc. Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar was a polymath, jurist, economist, politician, philosopher, anthropologist, sociologist, educationist, historian, writer, etc. Each person's many spheres of knowledge create a syncretic worldview that contributes to a broad perspective. Polymaths have the ability to see the connectedness among multiple domains of knowledge of the natural world and human interaction. But in the current challenges, it is very difficult to be a polymath. How? It is becoming difficult to get expertise in more than one sub-discipline. The academic system of rewarding greater specialization had fed the knowledge industry and universities to prepare students in precisely this manner. Policymakers are listening to the experts seeking their guidance, thus promoting further fragmentation. The assault on nature from the ramparts of specialization creates narrow viewpoints that are defended by specialists. Those at the short end are the most vulnerable creatures, and humans on earth make making up the last vast connected webs of life. So, if we see the arguments for generalist, we could say best leadership is provided by generalists who have a breadth of understanding and experience. Specialists, no matter how competent, tend to have a tunnel vision and are not equipped to take a broader view. Domain knowledge can be accomplished by domain experts advising the generalist leader in decision making. And what could be said in favor of specialist? That only someone who has learned the subject from the trenches can provide competent leadership in a functional area. So, what could be the way forward? The complex and interconnected nature of policy making demands that specialist expertise has to go with generalist experience. The Constitution Review Commission 2002 suggested that need to specialize some of the generalist and generalize some of the specialist. We can say that polymaths see the world differently. They make connections that are otherwise ignored, and they have the advantage of a unique perspective. In a world increasingly dominated by machines, I too have a feeling that this approach is going to become increasingly valuable.